that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, Ar-Rahman wa ala al-Arsh istawa, in many other places. Allah is saying that Allah rose over the throne. He said to Imam Malik, Ya Imam Malik, kaifa ar-Rahman wa istawa? How is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala risen over his throne? Tell me about it. Imam Malik rahmatullahi alayh, he got so angry, his face got red and there was sweat coming from his forehead. He had a stick which was rubbing on the ground with anger. He said to that person, then listen you, istawa ma'loom, that the raising is ma'loom, how a person raised, wa kayfa majhool, but how Allah is raising it is unknown. Imanu bil wajib, to believe in it is wajib, is obligatory. As-sawalu min bid'a, and asking this is an innovation. So he said, I think you are the person of innovation, so throw him out of the masjid. So Imam Malik rahmatullah alayh made him throw out of Masjid al-Madinah al-Munawwara, and he did not let him enter the masjid after that. We cannot love the person who has innovated, who has made new things in Islam. We have to hate them for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As many of the saying of the Salaf, the early scholars, if we read them, then we will see over there, we will learn from them, that they used to hate them. Even some of the scholars, one person came from Imam Shafi'i, rahmatullahi alayh. Allahu Akbar, may Allah have mercy upon him. A person came to him and said, Ya Imam Shafi'i, what do you say about the people of innovation, Ahli Ahwa, the Ahli Bid'a, what do you say about them? His student, one of Imam Shafi'i's students, rahmatullahi alayh, he said, if a person of innovation walks in front of me on the water and I can see it, I will not believe him. Meaning, if he shows me such a great karama, such a great thing that he's walking on the water, I will still not believe what he says, because he is a person of innovation. Imam Shafi'i rahmatullahi alayh said, my student has lagged behind. If I see a people of innovation flying, if I see him flying in front of me, he's flying in the air, I can see it, still I will not believe him. Subhanallah. A person came to Imam Abu Hanifa, rahmatullahi alayh. Imam Abu Hanifa, rahmatullahi alayh, was asked, where is Allah? Where is Allah? Aina Allah? Where is the Lord? Where is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Imam Abu Hanifa, rahmatullahi alayh, said, he is above the throne. He is above his arsh. He is not in this world. He is not part of the creation. He is above this creation. A person was sitting over there. He said that, Ya Abu Hanifa, Allah says in the Quran, I am with you. So how is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, I am with you, but you are saying that He is not with us? Imam Abu Hanifa, rahmatullahi alayh. Allahu Akbar. What great scholars. What great scholars those were, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed with the knowledge of Islam, blessed with the true understanding of Islam. Subhanallah. Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayh, he said that, Nissan, O you who is asking this question, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with you as you write a letter to your friend that I am with you, go over there. You are not with him, rather you are saying that I am with you, do not worry. Meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with you with his knowledge. He is with you with his knowledge. He knows what you are doing. He is aware of what we are doing. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with us. He is not with us physically. And Imam Malik rahmatullahi alayh, he said that unity, the brotherhood between Muslims, can be created by following the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah. And hatred and diversion will be created when following the innovation. These days many people say that these scholars, these people, these mullahs, these imams, they are making the Muslim diverted. They are making division among the Muslims. Wallahi, they are not making. They are only calling you to be united on the sunnah. They are only calling you to be united on Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can we love a person who is doing shirk? How can we love a person who is doing zabda, who is following the innovation? How can a true Muslim love him? When the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that the religion is complete, Allah said in the Quran, يَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتَ لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَضِيتُ عَنْهُ. That I've completed my favor, I've completed your religion for you. So how can a person innovate something better than the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Does it mean that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forgot to tell us about this? Does it mean that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not tell his Messenger about this? Does it mean that we know how to worship Allah better than the Messenger of Allah? So how can we love a person of innovation? How can we love a person of shirk? A true Muslim who has the love of Allah in his heart, who has the love of Islam in his heart, he cannot love that person. He cannot love the person who's following the innovation. He cannot love the person who's following his desires. Rather, we should love one another who are following Tawheed. We should call one another to the teachings of Tawheed. It is not the scholars, it is not the imams, it is not the mullahs who are calling division. It is us who are causing the division. When we refuse to follow the sunnah, when we refuse to be united on Tawheed, when we refuse to be united on the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we refuse that no, I will not leave worshipping the grave, I will not leave worshipping the dead people, this is when we are causing division. Rather, we should accept what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, glorified and exalted be He above all that the people ascribe with Him. We should be united on the teachings of Tawheed. And wallahi, my brothers, if today we all Muslims, we come back to the Quran, we come back to the Kitab, we come back to the Hadith, the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we come back, be united on the Seerah, on the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I am bearing this witness to this fact, and Allah is the best of the witnesses. He knows what is in my heart. Wallahi, I'm sure, 100% sure, if we get united today, no power on earth, no nation on earth will be able to stand in front of us. No nation on earth will be able to even touch us. No nation on earth will be able to raise their finger on us. Rather, they will be afraid of us. These days, the kuffar, the non-Muslims, they don't have the fear of the Muslims. That's why they are doing to the Muslim whatever they wish. Because we are disunited. They know that we Muslims don't have unity among us. Wallahi, my brothers, be united for the sake of Allah. Be united on the Tawheed of Allah. Be united on the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah. Leave the innovated ways. Leave the innovated direction. Leave the ways that lead to hellfire. Leave the ways that lead to shirk. And come back to the Tawheed. Come back to the oneness of Allah. Come back to the Sunnah of Allah. The teachings of Islam are already enough that much that people are not able to follow them. Why are we making new things? And you will see people that they love following the innovated ways, but they will not follow the Sunnah. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make me, make you, and make all the Muslims around the world follow the true teachings of Islam. Follow the true Tawheed of Allah. Follow the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with truth and sincerity. Ameen. All the truth is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He is as-salam. He is free from errors. And all the mistakes are from me or from the shaitan. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive me if I have said anything wrong. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us follow the truth if I have said anything right. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. All thanks and all praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who allowed me to speak and who allowed you to hear, who allowed you to come here. So all praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And may the best of His peace and salutations be upon the last of the prophets, the best of the prophets, the seal of the prophets, Muhammad ibn Abdullah, Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The purpose, the only purpose of today's khutbah, the only purpose of today's lecture was to remind those who have forgotten the Tawheed of Allah, who have forgotten about the teachings of Islam. Because human beings, they tend to forget. The human beings, they are created like this, that they do forget. So they need to be, you know, they need to be reminded again and again, including myself, because I am also a human being. I can also forget. And the only purpose was to teach those who do not know, who are not aware of the teachings of Islam. And it is only by the mercy and by the blessing of Allah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed me to speak. And all the truth was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And all the errors was from me. Because I am the one. Human beings, they do mistakes. And Allah is free from any kind of mistakes. Subhanallahi amma yasifoon. Subhanallahi amma yushrikoon. So all praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help the situations of the Muslim. Allahumma izzat al-Islam wa al-Muslimin wa zillat al-Kufara wa al-Mushrikeen wa zillat al-Yahood. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala curse the people. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroy the people who are hating the Muslims and who are plotting against the Muslims. Wa yamkuruna wa yamkur Allah. They are planning, they are plotting, but Allah also plans. Wa yamkuruna wa yamkur Allah. And Allah also plans. Wallahu khairul makirin. And Allah is the best of the planners. Inshallah, we will see the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala very soon. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help us. And the flag of La ilaha illallah and the flag of Islam will be high. And the world will bear witness to this thing. The world will see that Islam is the only right religion. The world will see that Islam is the only truth. Because Islam will raise.